Hello guys, and welcome to the fourth part of the MVVM tutorial series. In this part we will start to implement the recycler view and the adapter for that. So to start we want to create the XML layout for the recycler view for every item basically. So we go under our layout folder, right click new layout resource file. I'll name it sharpening item. And make sure the root element is a constraint layout because that will make it very easy to create it. Also, if you don't want to write the whole XML code by yourself, you can just click the link in the description to copy it from my GitHub. But nevertheless, I won't go into too much detail with XML, but I decided to include that in this tutorial. So to start, we will drag every element we need into our layout. So we need two text views, one for the name of a shopping item and one for the amount. And then we need three image views, which I will add in the text area here because then we don't have to set a source. So I'll write image view. We'll make it 35 dp times 35 dp, and yeah, that's it for now. We can copy that and paste it two times. So the first text view I will name TV name, the second one I will name TV amount, this image view I will give an ID IV delete, this one IV minus, and this one IV plus. Then I will make the text views a little bit bigger. So we set text size to 20 sp, also for this one. And then we need to import the image sources for our image views. So we go under drawable, new image asset, set as icon type action bar and tab icons, and this will be IC delete. We click on the clip art and type in delete. There's our trash can, so we click on that. As a theme we can choose Hololite to make it visible on our white background. Click on next, finish, and do the same for our minus and plus button. I see minus, click on the clip art, type in minus, or is it remove? Yeah, it is remove. Remove circle here. Hololite. Next and finish, and finally we can add our plus button. I see plus, and we write add, and there it is. Next and finish. So now we can add the source to our image views. This one is I see delete. This one is IC minus, and this one is finally IC plus. So because this is a constraint layout, we also have to set the constraints of each view. And to do that, we go under the design tab. We can drag the elements over a little bit to see them better. But first of all, I want to add some padding to our layout, like 16 dp. So now we can start with the trash can icon, drag it to the left, select the TV name text view, also drag it to the left and drag it to the top, select the TV amount text view and constrain it to the right and the top, the minus we can also constrain to the right and to that TV amount text view. We can also add a little bit of margin for that, like 16 dp. do the same for the plus, constrain it to TV amount, and to the minus button, add 16 margin to the right and 16 margin to the top. And finally, the trash can, we can constrain that to the name text view. And also add 16 dp margin. Finally, we have to set the layout height to wrap content, so the items in the recycler view won't fit the whole screen. So next, we want to create the adapter for our recycler view. To do that, we go under our main package, and I'll create a new package called other. Inside of that package, we will create a Kotlin file or class. Make sure it's a class and call it shopping item adapter. Our adapter will take two parameters in the constructor. First of all, the items, which is a list of shopping items. And it takes a private val view model, because we need to delete the data from our adapter, because we have the delete image view. So we need to call the delete function from the view model inside of our adapter class, which is a shopping view model. So this class will inherit from recyclerView.adapter, and this will take our view holder, which we will create in a sec. So we write shopping item adapter dot shopping view holder. That does not exist yet, of course, but I will create it right now. So we write in our class shopping view holder that takes an image view, which is a basic view, and it will inherit from recycler view dot view holder, which also takes the image view. And as you see, the error is gone, but we still have an error up here. That is why that is because we have to implement the methods for our adapter. For that, we press Control I and make sure to select everything, all those three methods, press OK, and Android Studio will insert them. Inside of this onCreateViewHolder method, we want to tell the recyclerView adapter which layout we want to have inside of our recyclerView. So that is the shopping item, which we created before. So we move the to-do tag, remove it, and inside of that, we'll write val view, which is equal to layout inflator dot from parent dot context dot inflate. Now we pass our created XML resource r dot layout dot shopping. Now we have to import that shopping item. Pass the parent as a second parameter and false for the third parameter. Then we will return a shopping view holder with our just created view. Next, the getItemCount method just needs the size of our recycler view, which is basically just items.size. And finally, onBindViewHolder, inside of that method, we will set all the values of our views, so for the text view, and we'll also set the onClickListeners for the image views. So first of all, I want to save our current shopping item in a variable, current shopping item, which is equal to items at our position. And then we want to set holder.itemView.tvName.text to current shopping item dot name. And do the same with the amount, holder.itemView.tvAmount.text is equal to, we have to do that with that dollar sign because it's an integer, and write current shopping item.amount. Then we will call holder.itemView.ivdelete and set the onClickListener to set onClickListener to our viewModelDelete function. Here we will call viewModel.delete and we want to delete our account shopping item. After that, we want to set the onClickListener for our plus button, holder.itemView.ivplus.setOnClickListener, right? And here we want to increase the amount before we want to update it in our database. So we say amount plus plus. And then we want to call viewModel.absurd account shopping item. And in this case, Room will recognize that this current shopping item is already in our database, so it will not insert a new entry with that shopping item. Instead, it will update the available entry with the new amount. So finally, we want to do that the same thing with our IV minus button dot set on click listener, and here we'll call current shopping item dot amount minus minus and call viewModel.absurd current shopping item again. But actually, we have to make sure that the amount is greater than zero, because otherwise we could have negative amounts, which we don't want here. Fine, that's it for the RecyclerView class. That's also it for this tutorial. That's everything I wanted to show you. I hope you like it. If you do, please comment below and give me some feedback, because then I can improve on my content and that would make me really happy. So have a good day and see you in the next video. Bye bye.